Hello and welcome, my dear students. In this module, we will learn further about the physical divisions of Asia. Here, we are going to learn about the central zone of mountains of Asia. Let's start. Next physical division in the list is the central zone of mountains. So, children, let's learn about it. First, you see in the map. If you see the brown region in the map, this brown region shows the central highlands or the central zone of mountains. You know, this region has several mountain ranges. In this map, you can see this whole region. There are several mountain ranges. So, they all form the central zone of mountains. Let's proceed. The central part of Asia is a vast area of highland and young fold mountains. Children, there are young fold mountains. So, young fold mountains are those mountains which are formed very recently in the planet, and they are very recent. Their origin is of recent geological period, and they are still growing. Their height keeps on increasing because of the process of folding. So, they are young fold mountains, most of them. Now, children, these mountains, they seem like coming out from a knot. Children, when we take a thread and we just twist it and stretch, we get a knot. So, there are two knots in Asia. One is Pamir knot and the another one is Armenian knot. We'll learn about them. Don't worry. We'll see in the map and we'll learn gradually. So, the Pamir knot, from that knot, it seems that mountains are coming out to, moving out to the west, east, and also towards the west. Similarly, in case of Armenian knot also, mountains seem like radiating out. They are coming out from that knot. It's not actually like that, but it seems. So, we have named them Pamir knot and Armenian knot. So, children, let's proceed. To the north of India lies the Pamir knot, where from where several mountains radiate out in all directions. Alright, so the first we'll see the map. So students, if you pay attention to the map, this is India. To the north of India is the Pamir. This is the knot called Pamir knot. And if you see carefully, you will find out, it seems that the mountains like Karakoram, Himalayas, Kunlun, Altun Shan, they are moving out from the Pamir towards the east. And the Himalayas further, they become Arakan Yoma and Pegu Yoma in Myanmar. So, towards the east radiate out Karakoram, Himalayas, Kunlun, Altun Shan, and it seems they are moving out from the Pamir knot. Now, children, towards the west moves out Hindu Kush, Suleiman. Then we have Zagros, Elbrus. And then further, if we move, we have the Taurus Mountains. So, students, these mountains, they are Hindu Kush, Suleiman. They are moving out towards the east from the Pamir knot. And the mountains like Karakoram, Himalayas, Altun Shan, they are moving out towards the east. So, Pamir is a knot from where it seems that the mountains are radiating out towards the east and towards the west. So, I hope, children, this is clear. Apart from this, you can see this picture. This is of Himalayas. You know, children, Himalayas, they occupy northern part of India and even other countries like Nepal, and they are in three parallel ranges, and the highest range is Himadri. The middle Himalayas are called Himachal, and the lower Himalayas are called Shivalik Himalayas. So these are the three parallel ranges of Himalayas. Himalayas further extend to Myanmar, and they are known as Arakan Yoma and Pegu Yoma. We have just seen in the map. Now, ranges lying to the east and west of Pamir we have already discussed. So we'll proceed. Among all the ranges of Himalaya, the Himalayas are the highest. Children, we have learnt about all the ranges right now which are coming out from the Pamir knot. That is the Hindu Kush, Chulaman. Then we have learned about Zagros, Elbrus. But among all, Himalayas are the highest, and Mount Everest is the world's highest peak. Students, all of us are aware of this fact. So this mountain peak is on the Himalayas. So let's proceed. Now the next concept which is important related to the central mountain is intermontane plateaus. Children, this is very important. Just you have to understand, and it's very simple also. Intermontane plateaus. So what are intermontane plateaus? Intermontane means plateau that is surrounded by mountains. Alright, so the plateaus that are enclosed by mountains. It's a very simple meaning. Plateaus which are surrounded by mountains are known as intermontane plateau. And the best example in Asia is the plateau of Tibet. The plateau of Tibet is an intermontane plateau. It is surrounded by several mountain ranges, and it lies between Himalayas and Kunlun mountains. So the plateau of Tibet lies between Himalayas and Kunlun mountains. Let's see. Plateau of Tibet, you can see Kunlun in the north and Himalayas in the south. So this is plateau of Tibet. It is an intermontane plateau because it is surrounded by mountains. Children, I hope this is clear. And you know, this is the highest plateau in the world. Its average height is 5,500 meters above sea level. Its average height is 5,500 meters. So you can imagine the height of the plateau. It is the highest plateau in the world. Children, this is a picture of the plateau of Tibet. You can see it out here. And this is another picture, again showing the plateau of Tibet. Then this is plateau of Iran. This plateau is again an intermontane plateau. You can see it is surrounded by ranges like Elbrus, Zagros. So this is another intermontane plateau. Then is plateau of Mongolia. So here lies the plateau of Mongolia. This is another important plateau which is in the central part of Asia. And you can see this plateau, and this map shows Mongolia. Mongolia lies in the Mongolian plateau, or the plateau of Mongolia. This is the another plateau, which is plateau of Anatolia. The plateau of Anatolia. You can see Mediterranean Sea in the south and Black Sea to the north. So this is plateau of Anatolia. Students, that's all about the central zone of mountains of Asia. Thank you very much.